Hello and welcome back to Call to Camera, the grand finale program in which we look at the art that you've snuck away with in isolation. So this is our final programme in which we've got four categories. I hope you're sitting comfortably, but I think you'll enjoy it really as much as we have. And the first of those is what I describe as genre paintings, or paintings of people doing things. And I suppose it's not altogether surprising in isolation that a lot of you have got a pleasure from looking at a painting in which somebody or a group of people are interacting. Human interaction is a very important subject matter, and I suppose it goes back particularly to 17th century Holland, where you get those genre scenes of taverns and everyday life. The atmosphere and almost the sound of them is part of the joy of what's happening before your eyes. Have a look at these though, because you too love the idea of something else going on in your house.
Deeper than you know, yeah, it weighs you down deeper than you know.
Our next category is still lives. It includes flower pieces. We get a lot of pleasure from the garden that we've got here, although we've been suffering from lack of rain, as I suspect many of you have as well. Anyway, still lives, the idea of looking at objects exquisitely painted, particularly goes back to the early 17th century in Holland. Before that, you would find objects in religious pictures, but they became a genre, an end in themselves. Some of these exquisite, beautiful, crystal clear renderings of fruit and glass abounded, particularly in Holland in 1600 to about 1650. And what better things to live with yourselves in isolation? Who needs the real thing when you've got the two-dimensional substitute? couple of people, by the way, have asked me about what this is, because we used it in an earlier film. It's a herm, which goes back to classical times, and it's a human form in a pillar, which was used sometimes as a sort of signpost or marking stone. It's a sort of semi-architectural thing. We bought it in Wychford Potteries locally. It's modern, and the modernist twist, of course, which won't have escaped your attention, is the fact that it doesn't have a head. I think it's a way of bringing it into the 20th century, rather radically. And this, of course, nicely brings me to our penultimate category, which is the figure, the human figure. And, well, there's no point really talking about the figure in art, because it basically is art, you know, from cave paintings to the modern day. But what I want you to do is look at these and think about how much people have enjoyed just having another human presence, either one or two. And I'm not talking about portraits, I'm just talking about that glorious subject, human anatomy. That painting that Oliver has just panned down from actually is a 20th century, probably mid-20th century, oil painting copy of a tapestry. Or is it possibly preparatory for a tapestry? I rather like the weird witticism of it not being a tapestry, but looking like a tapestry, an oil painting of a tapestry. If that doesn't sound too abstruse. And it's now time really to sign off from this whole series of call to camera, which has been so richly rewarding. It's been a sociological and artistic document, and I want to thank you all for giving us a slice of your life, the intimacy, if you want, of some of the things that are important to you. And I think going forward, all of these images, and there were, I don't know, about 600 in all, are going to be a diary of an extraordinary period of life, but a reminder of the importance of the visual, the way it can offer spiritual nourishment, how it can be company, how it can just bring oxygen, air and light into a lockdown existence. So thank you, and who knows, this might well one day be a book. More on that perhaps another time. And I want to leave you now with a small group of old masters. Yes, old masters, mellifluous, ancient things that people historically thought of as the only real art, early 20th century or late 19th century. But a lot of you, thank goodness, have old taste as well as modern taste. It's just another example of the rich variety of visual excitements that you've all been living with and will continue to do so. Speak to you soon, I hope. Bye.